topics, more questions is to come. So what are the things you have to know? The first thing is the different type of software used in bioinformatics. The FASTA is very well-known software for DNA and protein sequencing. DNA and protein sequence. Okay? Protein sequence. The alignment software. Alignment software. This is very important one. Okay? Then you have the next one is BLAST. This is also a software which is a basic alignment search tool. Basic alignment search tool. Search tool to compare sequence. Of nucleotide or amino acids. So you remember there were some basic biotechnical methods to identify the DNA sequence and the protein sequence are nothing but your Western blotting, then Eastern blotting, Northern, okay, Southern blotting. So Southern for DNA, Northern for RNA. So these things we have found out that sequence. Then you have our DNA sequencing like Sanger methods, okay. So these are the all old methods to find out sequence, but now this software will help us to compare the sequence, okay, and that's why this is one of the very good software in bioinformatics. Then you have some other softwares like tcoffee. What is that tcoffee? It is for multiple sequence alignment, for multiple sequence alignment. Okay, now after that you have UniProt, which is the free database of protein sequence. Then you have a special name of scientist, Smith Waterman, that is, I can write over here, Smith Waterman algorithm. Okay, algorithm. So what is that algorithm? This actually help us to understand protein and DNA sequence. So this algorithm is a basic for all your softwares. So this is these are the things bioinformatics you have to study from for NIPA. Then the next topic, let us go ahead for your physical pharmacy and novel drug delivery system. Physical pharmacy and the novel drug delivery system. Now for the physical pharmacy and the novel drug delivery system, we start with surfactants. So I have already discussed in our global classes, in the video class, okay, different type of surfactants, doing spans and different type of equations, okay, like E by P, then 1 minus S by A into 100, all these things, the surfactants formula, then how to evaluate surfactants, then your adsorption isotherms, BET equation, okay. Then coming to the rheology and surface tension, that all have mentioned in our video class and in our global regular class, rheology, surface tension. Then I have also explained zeta potential, DLBO theory, okay, Then you have Hofmeister series, Hofmeister, and then protective colloids, then your phase diagram, okay, your triple point concept. Then we have also dealt with suspension emulsion, that is, you know, already I have taught in the video class and as well as global regular class in our all branches in Mumbai. Then also you have to know solubility, okay. Then next thing is your stability and kinetics, which already I have discussed in our video. You can go to our YouTube channel, stability and kinetics, okay. Then after that you have stability, you have to know different type of climatic zones, okay, and stability condition, stability studies condition. Then for NDDS you must know osmotic pump. Then you know here, you know, there are different type of osmotic pump, push pull methods, okay. Then you have OROS. Then you have micro encapsulation, nanoparticle, liposome, and solid lipid nanoparticle. Just, you know, their method of manufacturing, the size of the dosage form, the advantage and disadvantage and the excipients used. Then you are done with your physical pharmacy. Then we go ahead for the pharmaceutical analysis. Pharmaceutical analysis is like I have already discussed in our global classes. So in for NIPER, what are the things you have to remember, you have to go through? Pharmaceutical analysis, see, the most important thing is we have analysis spectroscopic method, then you have chromatographic method, then you have electroanalytical methods, then you have number 4, thermal analysis method, and number 5, titrimetric methods, okay. So all the methods, you are required to know the principle and the instrumentation and the advanced form for NIPER, okay. Like for spectroscopic, you have UV, IR, NMR, mass, okay. Now for advanced things, you must know what is DEPT NMR, okay. We used in C13 NMR form, okay. Then you have what is LDOT, NDOT, okay. Then you have what is NOE. I have already mentioned in our global video class and as well as global regular class, okay. Then the relation between the Boltzmann, okay, and T1 and T2, that is relaxation time, okay. Then you have a famous equation of chemical shift, that, you know, Bx minus Btms upon B operating. So sometimes what happened, they will ask you that, you know, they give you this difference in hertz, this is in megahertz and this is in ppm, okay. Ppm means 1 upon 10 raised to 6. So, you know, maybe they will give you this difference and they will give you chemical shift, you have to find out the operating frequency, or maybe they will give you this two and you have to find out this difference. So this kind of sums they gives you, okay. Then you have the mass spectrometric technique. In mass, you have to remember all the advanced form of mass spectroscopic technique. Like you have your hyphenated techniques, the hyphenated techniques, LCMS, GCMS, okay. Then you have tandem mass spectrometric technique, that is your MSMS technique, okay. Then what is the limit of detection, different type of detectors, time of flights, okay. Then sometimes they ask that protein structure can be determined by which spectroscopic method. The answer is NMR, okay, especially 2D NMR. they identify the protein structure. Apart from that, you used to do with the Ramachandran plot, okay, and protein structure by X-ray crystallography, okay. So these are the techniques, but NMR is also a very useful technique. Then what is BPP theory in NMR? BPP theory. Then if for the mass, how to calculate metastable ion peak and different types of fragmentation. So this is also important. So you go through our global notes. Then in ICP-MS, what is the use for this? And then you have fluorescence, UV visible, colorimetric technique.